Hello, this is Rick Pena. I want to welcome you to another 5-Minute Fix. This is Purpose and Vision, Part 3. I trust that you've been blessed by Parts 1 and 2. And so let's just get into this thing, because I believe that God has really birthed this message in me for this year. So especially for this month, understanding our purpose and walking it out by receiving the vision. So let me differentiate real quick between purpose and vision. Purpose, I believe, is already fixed. It's predetermined, pre-established before we were born. So I just believe that every one of us, we saw that in the Word. I believe the Word confirms that. Every one of us was born for something, for a purpose. Our job then as believers is to find and follow, ultimately with the goal of finishing our purpose before we die. So that's what purpose is. Well, for us to finish our purpose, so to accomplish our purpose, we must receive vision from the Father. Vision takes us down the road of our purpose. And so vision, I believe, is incremental and progressive. Vision is sight, birth from insight with the benefit of hindsight. And since it's with the benefit of hindsight, then that means that since I can look back, then the more I have to look back on, the greater vision I'm gonna have. Okay, said another way, the more experiences I have with the Father, the more encounters I have with Him, the more faith fights I go through and endure and win through the Word, then the greater vision I can have. So in other words, you and I, we can accomplish more in God today, prayerfully, than we could 10 years ago. And it's not that God changed, it was that we changed. So as you expand your capacity to believe God, then the Father is able to show you things on a greater level. And it, once again, it's not that He changed, it was that you changed. And the more you change, the more you open yourself up to receive from the Father, the more you can accomplish in and through Him. And the more He can accomplish in and through you. So let me give you an example with Abraham. He comes to a man who's 75 years old. He has a 65-year-old wife, and they never had any children. In Genesis 12, God says to Abraham, I'm going to bless you. I'm going to make your name great. And through you shall all the families of the earth be blessed. I believe that was his purpose. His purpose was to be the conduit, the channel, the vehicle through which the Father would establish a family and bless the entire earth. However, Abraham needed to receive vision from the Father so that he could accomplish his purpose. The vision would take him down the road to purpose accomplishment. And so Abraham needed the vision. One time when Abraham was frustrated because he didn't have the child yet, the Lord takes him outside one time. It's at night, and he says, look up. He looks up at the stars and he says, listen, do you see the stars? Yes. Well, just like you can't count the stars, you won't be able to count the number of children you're gonna have. That's how many children are gonna come through your bloodline. That's how many children are gonna be in your lineage. What was he doing? He was trying to get him to expand his vision, to be able to see it. You gotta see it before you can be it. You will never exercise the faith for something that you can't see yourself doing. Another time, it was during the day, he takes him outside, says, look down at the grains of sand or at the molecules of dust. Just like you can't count the dust, just like you can't count the sand, you won't be able to count your children, your lineage. Once again, he was trying to get him to expand his vision. If it was at night, Abraham could look up. If it was during the day, he could look down. And these were reminders for him to expand his capacity to believe, to expand his vision. This is where I believe imagination comes in. Imagination, Rick? Yeah, I mean imagination. But listen, anointed imagination. I don't mean just like you sitting around imagining just wishful thinking based upon nothing. But I mean, this is imagination based upon your encounter, your experience, your relationship with the Father. And an anointed imagination session. I believe that you can sit down, pray, and the Father with your imagination can show you your future. He can actually take you there. You walk around, you see buildings, you see people, you see faces, you come in contact with people, you have conversations, relationships, shake hands, see who you're gonna be a blessing to, and then you come back to reality, you come back to the present, and you make plans to get there. You literally can make the plans to get there, but your plans must line up with God's purpose. Because if they're not lined up with God's purpose, they will not experience divine success. That's why I say it has to be an anointed imagination session, not just something you come up with, but something He births in and through you. So a couple of things here as we close. Purpose will give birth to vision. Vision will inform your plans, If your plans are lined up with your purpose, then the Father will be involved in your plans. He will bless your plans. He will empower your plans to prosper. And then lastly, this is a key nugget. When the Father shows you a glimpse of your future, when he shows you, or if he sends somebody to tell you, to give you a prophetic word, either way, when he gives you a confirming word of your future, then this is confirmation of what he has already implanted inside of you. Why? Because he will never tell you to do something that you cannot do. So when he shows you your future, or he sends a word about your future, he is confirming what's already on the inside of you. Your goal then is the outworking of the internal. It's to get out of you what the Father has impregnated you with. And when you really believe it, when you meditate that thing, if you allow the imagination to become so big to where you really believe it, then just like a woman in travail, you will have this thing. You will be so pregnant with purpose that you gotta get it out. And then you will experience the outworking of the internal, because it will be so big on the inside that you gotta see it on the outside. This is purpose. This is vision. I'm excited about this series. Listen, we got two more to do. Make sure you come back next week. This has been a blessing to me, and I pray that it's been a blessing to you. I'm Rick Pena, and I'm out of time. This has been your 5-Minute Fix. God bless you.